Hello everybody. As you know, I'm French speaker, so my English will be very simple. I hope images will speak by themselves in a way. So this is, we can say, my first serious book, comics book I made, and it's what we can say an autobiography. But since the beginning of my work, I wanted to put in question the idea of autobiography and think about all limits we can hear about what it means an autobiography. In that book, I told about a serious difficult period I had had during my childhoodness, because I subit some violence, mostly from my mother, and I knew during my study that I absolutely want to make something with this material of life. Especially because on that time, and before, and since that time, I had a very big problem with this past, and I always have the need to speak about to everybody I meet, and generally in the five first minutes. So it brings me a lot of other problems, because in place of receive all the attention and empathy I needed, in general I made people totally afraid, and they quickly try to find some excuse to escape rapidly the subject. So I knew that maybe the fact to transform all this past and troubles maybe can put all of them in distance. So I started this book when I finished my study, and I immediately decided to make it with l'association, because on that time l'association started to develop the genre autobiography, when in States it was already made for a long time, but in France not. So it was around the 90s, and this movement became very, very important in Europe because of l'association. The difficulty to speak about our past, our life, is naturally to engage and involve people we know very well, and how we are allowed, and what we are allowed to say about them. And especially, naturally, when it's your parents or direct family. Because naturally, in a way, you condemn a little bit what they are, and you show their weakness and the bad part to the world. So I started this book, but my problems was that I have with my mother a very strange relation, which was not all the time bad. The special thing was that my mother and me, we were in a way very close to each other, and she could be the best and the worst in the same person. So one of her particular reality was that she regularly split our relation, and this period could be very long, sometimes 2 years, sometimes like now, like something like 7 years, or And I knew that each time she will come back, but each time she will break again. So each time she came back, the book I was working on couldn't continue because it was too difficult to be too close of her. And during one time she came to me, donc I studied the first 20 pages that you can see here. And I also wanted to speak about my two parents because the problems was in fact not only my mother but also my father, because my father was not very helpful for me because he was deeply alcoholic. So I started with these pages, and after the first chapter I stopped because my mother came back. So meanwhile I started another book, which is this one, called Souvenir d'une journée parfaite, Souvenir of a Perfect Day. And this book is again the opportunity to think about what is fiction and what is autobiography. I started this project in 2000 by a proposition to make something around Brussels, a story about Brussels. So at that time, my father was died 1 year before. And his body was burned. I don't know how you say it. Voilà. And his ashes put, voilà, spring in the grasses somewhere in a cemetery. And when we do that in Belgium, the name is not immediately put on a big stone with 100 other names, but some weeks after. So the year after, I decided to go back in this cemetery to see if I can find his name without asking anybody where is the goblet name. And I started to read names and names, and regularly I stopped on names that attract my attention. It could be like a child with a date or some name who, for a reason, catch your attention, and without, unconsciously, you start to imagine life of people. For example, one man I saw on this stone was called Jules César. Jules César, which is a name I think not so easy to wear on that time. No. So, like that, I saw this name, Matthias Kahn, and I started to imagine his life. So this book is building on a double construction. First, the life of Matthias Kahn, then again this research of my father's name. And in the middle, the two stories cross by this procession, which could be my father's procession or Matthias Kahn. What I realized by making this double construction is that in the part autobiographic that I developed, this research of the name of my father that I didn't find, because suddenly the ring belt and everybody must go out of the cemetery, so unluckily I didn't find him. And we can say it's an autobiography because I told something about the reality of what I'm living at that moment. But what do you know about my life by this autobiography? Nothing, except that my father is dead. But through the part I speak about this man, Matthias Kahn, I insult, comme ça qu'on dit, I put a lot of personal informations, because how to invent, how to create a story about someone like that that you don't know? Naturally, you dig in yourself and you take some element and you tell a story. But even if you try to make a kind of fiction, it's always a part of you. And this was something very interesting for me to start to think about the limit of autobiography, comment on dit ça, autofiction and fiction. So we come back now to the autobiography. 2 years after this split, I decided to start again with this book. But when you put in when you froze, you put in frozen in ice some project, when you come back, you cannot continue as you imagined 2 years ago. You must change, otherwise it's boring. So you must rethinking. And it's very interesting to have the possibility to start several projects in the same time, and sometimes to let it sleep for a while, because when you come back, your spirit take distance and can be more fresh and more renew. I decide at that moment to mix my present life to my past, and on that time I was living with my lover, a story a little bit difficult but very classical, a separation and all the difficulty with a partner. And I decided because this partner was not totally separate of his ex-girlfriend, and I wanted to find a metaphor to speak about this presence of this other girl without really tell everything. I decided to play with the pattern of ghost, because when you are like that in a relation and you feel someone else, it's like somebody can be all the time with you, but you don't see the person, a little bit like the presence of the ghost. And you see that I play and this is the other important aspect of my work. It's the fact that I'm always very interested about how to feed a field like comics. I think the best thing is not to take your influence or not to read too much comics. If you want to make good comics, go outside and be fascinated by cinema or dance or theater or literature, but don't read too much comics, because fascination is very dangerous, in my opinion. When we are too much fascinated by other work, it's very difficult for us to be ourselves. But if you take your influence outside, you make the field more rich by finding other code, being attentive about the stereotypes of the genre, and finding the way to push as far as possible the limit and the border of the genre. And this is one of my first interests of what we can make with comics, maybe being interested in my case in photographies or especially contemporary art, and see how it's possible to make it enter. So here you see my young life of mother. I was mother of a small daughter, 4 years old. And in the third chapter, you see me, the last image, me as a child. And I try to approach this very, very difficult part of my life. And especially when punishment was so it was like an image which come back all the time, because when I was a child and we make some problems, sometimes my mother became totally crazy, and she decided to put me or my brother in the attic, and she wanted to make this very impressive. And because in the attic it was a lot of very old things, like a Christmas mess and so on, she said maybe it will be very funny to be in the attic, so I don't want it's funny. And then she linked me by hand at the roof of the attic to stay there for a while. I don't know exactly how much time. So how to tell a story like that without being too pathetic, or I don't want to make people crying, or I don't want to make some melodrama, but how to take the good distance. So I start first to find, I decide first to take distance and try to tell only fact. So it was a dispute, in a quarrel. So my mother exploded. She took me in the attic, and you know what happened. And then I finish the book. We come back again with the last part is the part, I don't have it, pas grave. The last part finish on the love again, and it finish good. And I give this book to my publisher. And I was really happy. It took 12 years to make the whole book. And I give it to my publisher. And he read and said, "Dom, it's super, but I must be honest. And when I read this third chapter, I must confess that I didn't feel anything." Not anything, but something like, it seems that you tell something about you go in the post office, and it's not very touchful. Okay, super, big success. I didn't want to be too much melodramatic, but if you feel anything, is it okay? And I was really nervous when he said this to me, and I was, "Tu fou, how it's possible?" And he said, "No, but I'm obliged to say you, if it's what you want, I will publish like that because your book is good, but I must say this." And I said, "Of course I want this, I'm disgraceful, and I don't want to say too much and so on." He said, okay, I will publish it. But naturally, the day after, I was thinking, no, it's not okay. Quoi. And I started again all the third chapter. And I realized that maybe I pass. I pass through what I must say, because I realize that facts are in fact nothing. Facts are not. You can speak about a rape. You can speak about violence. If you don't find something about your trueness, it's nothing. Facts are nothing. And what was my trueness? My trueness was that even my mother was in that sense, was kind of monster sometimes. My trueness was that I loved her so much. This was my trueness. So the challenge is, if I can make you feel this, this person, even if she makes some horrible thing to her child, you can love her. You can feel something good. It's very difficult. It's a very big challenge. And I was thinking about, okay, why did I love my mother like that? I loved her like that because she spent a lot of time with us. Mostly by playing some games with me. And I'm thinking, okay, I will put these two events together. Even if I don't remember, it's true. I mean, the attic and just after a game. I will put these two together. So it's interesting again, because again, it's questioned the idea of autobiography. Autobiography seems to be the trueness, the reality. But in fact, I think it's not totally the case. Because, by the way, if I had asked my mother to tell the same story, you will have another story, totally different. And another fact is the, comment on dit encore, le montage, the editing. You take this, you choose this, you choose this, and then you put together and you make the link. But another person will take another moment and put another object. And okay, I decided to make the two things together because I had the feeling that if I can bring the two elements together, which are in total opposition, I can express my deep feeling about my mother, which is my trueness. And I was thinking, what game I could take as an example? And we made a lot of games, like Monopoly, chess, or what you can imagine. But there was one we played all the time. And when suddenly I thought about this game, and I never till that moment think about the title of this game, it was crazy. Because this game, called in French, ne t'en fais pas, which means don't worry. Wow, this is something crazy. My mother punished me, and a punishment horrible, really hard. She put me out of the attic and she proposed me a game. Which game? Don't worry. Voilà. To me, this is autobiography. After this book, when it was finished, I started a new book. And this is Nikita, my daughter. I became myself mother. And as you can imagine, I was wondering about my mother behavior and how I will be as a mother. Am I obliged to repeat what's happened in my childhood? maybe I will avoid or what. But the trueness was that it was not evident for me, love, you know, mother instinct and so on, was not a total evidence for me. So I was thinking, maybe I must make some work to find myself also, the response of this question of relationship with my daughter. So I was starting a kind of sketchbook. Each time I saw Nikita in a special moment and I feel this sudden emotion, deep emotion, I was running, take my sketchbook, start drawing to try to transform in an image the feeling I had at that time. But I quickly noticed that it's not really interesting because it doesn't speak about the link. It's only an accumulation of lovely drawing of my lovely little child. Oh, it's so cute. So, again, thinking about link, what is link and what is love in the link and why did I love my mother? I love my mother because we spent time together. So time to me is one of the most important acts in relationship, but also in art and what we can, how we can use time and how we can involve time in your work. And suddenly I think, okay, I have an idea. At that time I was separate with the father. Nikita was with me 1 week on two. And I proposed to Nikita one day, she was 7, would you like if we take a kind of appointment 1 per week? And during that moment, I would draw you, I would make a portrait of you, and after you will make a portrait of me. And we could do that for 10 years running, for example. What do you think about that? Oh yes, super. She answered very freely and happy because, yes, 10 years for her, when she was 7, it's nothing, a big abstraction. So she didn't realize that soon, teenager period and so on. Naturally, the deal could be stopped if she stopped being interested by this... because we cannot force a child. I would love, but it's not possible. It's not possible to force a child drawing with me. So now I will show you some pictures and I will continue to explain after. So this was the two first drawing was the drawing I made about Nikita. Oh, it's so big. Can you help me too?
Sure.
Voilà. That was the first drawing Nikita made with me. Voilà.
Yeah,
oui, je vais bouger. Oui, oui.
Close
enough. And she was a 7. And rapidly, after 2-3 months, 1 per week, in fact, 1 every 2 weeks, because she was one per week, 1 week on two. We draw each other. And at least, luckily and happily, we made this for 10 years. So from her 7 till 17, we draw each other and take this time for being together and share my language with my daughter and trying to answer this question. And I think this project answered perfectly my question because yes, it was full of love. Voilà. There is a lot of light. I don't know if you see very well. Yes? Quite well. Voilà, bon, bref. So, this is the TOS project I wanted to speak about. And now I will present you a more recent book I made. This is called Plus si on tente. I don't know if there is a translation for that, but it's a French expression to say if it click together, we can go further. Generally, you find this in, on website to meet some people. So, I will present you the process of that book, because that book is a collaboration with Kai Pfeiffer, a German artist that I met in a festival in Stockholm. We both have this interest for putting all codes and everything in question and all stereotypes, and to see what is possible to consider as least. Ah oui, j'oubliais de dire encore. I forgot to say something very important about Chronographie, which is the book I made with my daughter. This book, Chronographie, was published by l'association. And it was the first book they made, we can say, out of the regular comics. And the funny thing was that because it was 600 pages, so it's 2 kilos, it's heavy, huh? Naturally, it was a big challenge, and I mean financially, because they don't know if they will sell the book, and it's only double portrait. Will people be interested by that, and especially if it's published by a comics publisher? It's very dangerous for them. It's a big risk. So in France, I don't know how it is here in States, but in France, you have the possibility to receive some kind of, not grant, but help, government help for artistic project. So this is for artists, but a publisher also can receive it, some help for a difficult project. So they ask to the commission, comics commission, for this project with Nikita, which is funny, because can we still consider this as a comics project? Probably not, but we also could imagine that it's the very, very wide idea of a narration. And there is a sequence, because you cannot remix the book. It's a following. So it's a story. Yes, it's true, there is not a lot of text, but it tells a lot. So what's the idea of comics, and what can we still consider comics? So they ask this help in comics commission, and they receive it. That's the surprise. And by the way, this book was nominated in Angoulême as one of the best fifth comics of the year, which is incredible again. I'm proud of that, not because of being selected, but because it makes border moving, which is my big interest. And I think it's really wonderful. And this, why I wanted to present this, it's because this project, Plus si on tente, is again an experimentation about narration and what we can make with comics. I met Kai in that festival, And we wanted to work together. And I said, okay, send me a proposition. And this is what he sent it to me. This lovely page, very trash, sexy trash. I was totally shocked, to be honest, because I never had work with sexuality thematic before of that book. And what he proposed to me is this game. He's in Berlin and I'm in Brussels, so we cannot work together at the same table. All pages will be composed exactly on this model, 4 panels per page. And we work on a thematic, love on internet website research. You know, this website, you must go to find lovely men, sportive and so on. And you are a beautiful 20 years girl when you are 50, naturally. You can write what you want. And the idea was, each time we finish a page, we send to each other, and the other one can react or not on what he receives. Because the idea is only on the beginning, producing images till 100 pages. And when we would have 100 pages, we will recut all images, remix everything, and see if it's possible, based on this image bank, to create narration. So it reverses the classical approach in comics, where you normally write a story, then you cut all part, then you start the storyboard, and then you draw. Here we start by the opposite way. So I will show you a little bit now what it gave. So the first 5 images was the image Kai sent it to me, which convinced me immediately to play with him. Allez. Voilà. And this was the first drawing I made. The fun idea was that we could, as I said, react on the page of each other, but not only in a sense of, in a narrative sense. So yes, we can continue if I make an action, he can continue this action, but we also can play only with a kind of poetic aspect of the images, like a declination, comment on dit ça, une déclinaison? Variation of a theme, but an image theme, which became poetic aspect, like a little, like what you have in music, for example, with les variations de Gould, de
Goldberg variations.
Voilà. You have a sentence, and this sentence can be reused several times. For example, this page I gave to Kai, and you will see. If you see, for example, the second panel with the legs and the boxer, he remixed this with these legs, and all the drawing were reused, but by a kind of play. And then he continued on this pattern, the legs, the boxer, to make even, so you see the first panel, and then he make this one. And again, you see the boxer, but it began abstraction. So everything is possible. We can play all what we want. It's still comics, but it's also in a kind of way conceptual or something like that. Abstraction. Voilà. So the fact is that when we arrived at 100 pages, in fact, against us, against our, comment dire, conscious, a kind of skeletus was already existing. So clearly, some character born by themselves, a woman, 50 years old, that you can see just after. Voilà, she's in her bed, looking for men on internet website. And at least the book is her story, but more in the view of her fantasy. And in her fantasy, she will invite all these men all together at the same moment, the same day, the same place, her house and her garden. So this begin the big play. Here you can see some men she crossed on the website, and we both inscribe ourselves on the website to see a little bit the vocabulary, typical vocabulary. It was so funny because we found a wonderful website. I really advise you if you need, especially for men, because it's a little bit olé olé. It's mignonne.com, mignonne, cute, cute.com, cute.com. So you can imagine the sort of message and proposition you have on this website, but very poetic. And it was so incredible. It was a source of inspiration and poetic aspect. It was crazy, so funny. For example, some people write a little bit too quickly, maybe with an iPhone or I don't know, by driving or... And sometimes they forget some word or they make mistakes, and these mistakes are sometimes amazing, like treasure. Hein? For example, we noticed that the word the most used by men was, in French, sans prise de tête. I don't know if there is a translation.
Without head games.
Voilà. No head Can you games. Say...
Like no head games, manipulations.
But it means without any day after or without too much question, don't ask me if I'm married or... don't ask me too much, don't push me, don't make pressure.
No strings.
Voilà, voilà. And... literally, it means without taking heads, sans prise de tête. And one man, it's this one, for example, Laris, he wrote, I am a young African, I'm looking a young woman without head. Because unfortunately, he forgot important word. Maybe not that important, because a woman without head is more easy. Voilà. Je vais peut-être un peu vite. Hein. You don't see anything. Okay, I start again. Wait. Hello. We don't see anything, I'm sorry. Here it's come on, I have so much place for your love. This bush you can see on the first panel is an important character or in our story. Yes, it may be better to switch off. Yes. Yoo-hoo! This bush is really important because it was in a house near Brussels, and we saw this bush in front of a little house in a very strange suburb around Brussels. And it's a Flemish part, and all the houses are similar, with all same gardens, all same mailbox, and funnily, all houses has three windows with the same vases inside. But one house has this strange bush. I think the couple who lives there are have a lot of personality because they cut the bush in a strange form of penis. And this bush arrived at the first floor of the house. So when you open the door, you are just above this wonderful penis. Yes, who is there? And I'm sure the people didn't think it looks like a penis, but they wanted a mushroom probably. Because I saw one day they coming out of the house, and they were very old and look very serious. Maybe they're full of sense of humor, but I'm not sure. And I will show you after the picture, the real picture of the real bush. Voilà. This is the idea of this book. In the middle of that book, there is a double page of the garden, which called Le Jardin des Candidats. And based on this double page, we started all our work we decided to create an extension of the book for exhibitions. The idea was to create another proposition based on this idea of Le Jardin des Candidats. Donc, all these men, naked or with some little underwear, are waiting, crying in the garden, waiting for the mother, who is a little bit forgetting them because she never appears. So meanwhile, they must be a little bit kind for each other and patient. So this is the view of the third version we made of this exhibition. And we mixed this with some object. You saw the vases, which is a pattern very important. Voilà. Here you see a collection of vases. And here some pot holder, which begun for us a beautiful abstract pattern, but also a wonderful symbol of something you need to protect yourself when you want to approach something too hot, like the mother love. And after this, we made we put this exhibition in St. Petersburg Nabokov Museum. But this is the garden. Huh? We had a small problem with with Simpet Augsburg, because they said to us that there is a little bit too much nudity. No nudity. A man like that, very, very serious. No nudity. Okay, but okay, what can we do now? You can put off all drawings where there is nudity, but it was quite a lot. So we said, okay, we will manage and we will play with that because we like to play. And we said, okay, we will hide all nudity. And the responsible of museum said, no, no, we don't want you show that we censor you. So if you want to hide, use the same color. All drawings are in green, as you saw. And they want it. We put some kind of leaves, green leaves, on each small penis. And I was not agree, because, okay, I agree to hide, because I must pay attention about sensibility of Russian people. But I cannot, if they censor me, they must assume. It's not my problem. So here you see some, we add some small solution on each, voilà, for example, this. And it was so ridiculous because we naturally saw more, we pay more attention than before. And in fact, the big problems was we understood that in Russia, there is a new law against homo...
propaganda.
Voilà. And they were afraid to have some problems because they consider that we encourage homo... comment? Comment? J'ai pas compris. Oui, gay. And it was totally false, naturally, because all that men was focused on the mother. But even when we explained that, they didn't accept or... Attends. Oui, mais ça va vite, mais c'est difficile à contrôler le...
You can use the arrows here.
Ah, okay, okay. I will do that. And... the funny thing was that... ah oui, ça c'est bien aussi. The funny thing was that we had only one image with the mother naked here. And we put some post-it on the breast. But they say, no, no, this is not necessary. And I said, huh? Why? And they said, because it's less realistic. You draw the woman as a cartoon, and the man is too realistic. Okay, I didn't really understand, but other point of view, other world. Okay, and now I will finish by present you the real the real Bush and Kai and ça va, ah oui, comme ça je vais faire. Voilà, the real house with the real Bush. Voilà. And when the book, and after that I finish. When the book came out, it was, I don't know if you heard about this scandal in France with Paul McCarthy and the plug, you know, plug anal. Attends, est-ce qu'il est? Voilà, this one. And we decide when we saw this, hey, McCarthy copy us. This is a big scandal. So we decided to play with this and to make like after that, after the big scandal of Paul McCarthy, we also receive a censure about our book, and we pretended that we put this on Facebook, but really as a joke. And we pretend that the Amazon obliged us to censor our cover and to transform it by everything must be a cover, recover. I think I have the version with R, don't see nothing. J'ai plus aussi. Je ne trouve plus. Chut. Je sais que je l'ai, mais... Bon, je ne le trouve pas. We transform all our cover by putting a lovely chemisier on our mother and some... And we put this on Facebook. And we thought that every people will understand it's a joke, but in fact it produced a terrible buzz that we didn't expect, and everybody was so shocked, wow, dégueulasse, censure, and so on. And we were a little bit, oh shit, what we have done. And some people said, hey, you make this on purpose to have the buzz and so on. And we see. And then, because too much people believed on the story and were really shocked, we decided to continue to put every day a picture on internet to make people understand by themselves that is a joke. So after this cover that we transform, we put these pictures where you can see. Tu peux mettre un peu plus petit la photo, smaller. Voilà. Where we pretend that after our book, there is a big scandal about even the bushes. And that policemen must stay around because these bushes receive some direct menace, threat. Voilà. And we put these pictures on internet, which is clearly a Photoshop. Even though people continue, no, not possible. Voilà, this is the story. Thank you very much for your attention.